Hi, racing fans. Mellow Yellow, the world's fastest soft drink, presents Denise Boudreau and Kim Rice, two of the world's fastest jockeys in a fast drinking race. And they're off. Denise takes the lead with her lemony smooth Mellow Yellow. But here comes Kim with her great tasting Mellow Yellow. It's a photo finish. Now it's official. Kim by a nose. Mellow Yellow. No wonder they call it the world's fastest soft drink. It's the favorite.
The news people at 11. Programming normally seen at this time will not air in order to bring you the following program. Stay tuned now for PM Magazine.
When the sun goes down, the rhythm of the working world slows down. But that quiet pace lasts just long enough for business people and bus drivers, teachers and technicians, salespeople and computer analysts to get ready for another world. It's a world where public relations is who you meet. A big order is a round of drinks, and an ad campaign might be as simple as a smile.
Nighttime is the world of the swinging signals. And these days, you don't know what you're going to find as that age-old ritual of searching for a mate begins. Though pairing off may be as old as Noah's Ark, today it takes a lot more imagination and innovation. Not only in how to meet people, but what to do with who you've met. Hi, I'm Bill Rafferty, and that's what we're doing tonight, taking a look at how people are mating and dating in the 80s. Up until now, one of the most common places to meet members of the opposite sex has been the singles bar. Now, like it or not, first impressions here are very important, and so is what you say. Opening lines shouldn't sound like opening lines. Or to put it another way, fine lines are like fine wines. Personable, but not ostentatious.
Hi, I'm from out of town. Can you show me the way to your house?
Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but I got the best approach of all. Hi. You see that camera? See the lights? Want to be on TV? Works every time. Of course, there are some places where being a successful single is more than having a good come-on line. We're headed for one right now. Why don't you join us?
Our whole trip tonight will take about an hour, but wait till you see where it takes us.
The fun's only beginning as our final destinations are the same ones shared by most singles finding partners in the high-tech, fast-paced, liberated era of the 80s. We'll be looking at some of the new ways singles are finding other singles, from tennis games, where love hopefully doesn't mean zero, to TV shows where ratings don't mean how many people watch, but how much they like what they see. We'll see how modern men and women are getting away from it all and getting together at a franchise chain of paradise retreats, and how they're turning the tables at nightclubs where the guys put on the shows for gals. Plus, we'll see how finding a date is getting easier at all single apartment houses, where modern conveniences include a built-in set of friends. And even how getting married and going on a honeymoon has taken on the posh look of the 80s. Now, I don't know about you, but this next hour should be a lot more fun than that interesting evening you spent with that friend of your sister-in-law's with a great personality. We'll be right back.
Tonight, steaks a la Murray.
Yay!
Yeah, the grill's too filthy to clean now. Let's eat out.
Don't put it off. Use your Easy Off.
Easy Off oven cleaner on a barbecue grill?
Spray it on. The foaming action turns hard black grease soft, brown, and soapy. Sponge and rinse.
The grill's clean. You're cooking, Murray.
Don't put it off. Use your Easy Off.
And let them eat steak.
Easy Off makes grill cleaning easier.
These are tough times for the family budget, but LK will promise you this. The best value for the money. Looks great, Barb. We've been living up to this for 35 years, whether it's a meal at an LK restaurant or a room in an LK motel or Penny Pincher Inn. You can be sure of this. You'll get your money's worth and more every time. That's a promise of LK wherever you go this summer. And this is a good sign that your dollar will go a lot farther.
Our next stop on the Nighttime Express roars like a subway train, shakes like a 9.8 on the Richter scale, and dazzles like an opening night every night. It's the dance floor of the 80s, right? Welcome to the flash and glamour of the disco circuit, where the only opening line you need is, do you want to dance?
I do.
All right. Wow.
Once you're on the dance floor, getting to know someone is relatively easy, because even the most tongue-tied can be an expert in the art of body language. And this way of expressing yourself seems to be very popular. There are 20,000 discos in America today, and it is estimated that altogether they play 2 million records a night. Some would say it's the same record played 2 million times, but whatever they're playing at the moment, it seems to be somebody's song.
I think it could be this much fun. It always looked like work to me. For most people, a night at a disco is like a day at Disneyland. The noise, the lights, the excitement all add up to a spontaneous outburst of fun and pleasure. But what is the truth is that all this magic is run by a technical wizard. Hit it, darling. Ow!
He programs a computer which controls bright lights, video screens, constant music, and even the room temperature, cash register, and inventory control. But at a disco in Maryland, a computer is also used as a gimmick to bring singles together. No, these people are not part of a human scramble game. It's the newest game singles are playing, Selectrocution. Singles are tagged with initials when they enter, and if you see a pair of initials which attract you, simply write them down along with your message. The message is then flashed via computer onto the screen. If they decide to meet you, that's known as making initial contact. The inventor says that this method of meeting people avoids the face-to-face confrontation that makes so many people nervous. At the end of the evening, the computer prints out the complete results of just who wanted to meet who. It's a way of keeping score while you're trying to score.
I just got a date with my phone bill. Computers can match people up by personality, physical trait, and that good old standby astrological sign. However, there is a unique computer service in Philadelphia, a service that can be an ace, a slice, and a good old-fashioned over-the-hand slam.
Tennis 2 is mixed doubles or tennis parties for singles created by an enterprising young woman who, like many others, wanted an alternative to the singles bars and discos.
It's attracting a really nice group of people who are athletic, who have something in common, and who can talk about tennis instead of just trying to think of something to say to introduce themselves.
Mixed doubles is unique because a computer matches people as to their ability to play tennis. The idea being that two equally poor backhands could someday evolve into a real love match.
You know, here you're playing tennis, and everybody has tennis as a common thing to talk about, and after a while, people become their real selves rather than the phony type of people you'll see in a bar.
And it's just an easy way to get into the singles social scene, because you look like you're not looking, really. And basically, you're really not. You're coming to have a good time, and if you meet somebody, it's a bonus, and if you don't meet somebody, you still had a nice time. And that's the basis of it.
Performance on the court is no assurance of off-court behavior. But no matter what your playing ability or demeanor is, by providing mixed doubles for singles, tennis, too, is a net gain.
Now, we've seen examples of sex in socializing, sex in scientific selection, and even sex in sports. But suppose you consider yourself a little too refined, too mature, too full of savoir-faire. Perhaps you'd prefer something a little more sophisticated. Today's technology permits us to see and not be seen. In the privacy of a video dating office, one can pick and choose from any number of possible acquaintances on videotape. The motto in the 60s was turn on and tune out. In the 80s, thanks to video dating, the motto will be tune in and possibly turn on.
Video dating is another way to solve the problems of breaking the ice. All a video dater has to do is first fill out a personality profile. Then they are taken into a room where a tape is made of them. After the audition, each of the video daters sits down to screen prospective partners.
This is the couple company, take number 1976. And we're introducing Jerry. Welcome, Jerry. Nice to have you with us.
Good to be here.
Now, outside of your professional life, what kinds of things do you like to do for fun?
Movies, clubs now and then, going out to eat. I was excited. I couldn't wait to get here and actually see what was going to happen. The whole show itself, making the tapes, filling out the application, and actually viewing some tapes. I just couldn't wait to look at a couple of tapes and say, actually, what I was going to be actually viewing.
Yes, I do feel like I'm trying to sell myself to someone. In a very low-key way. You know, here I am, I'm fun to be with. I enjoy people's company very much. I enjoy men very much. And I would like to get together with someone else who would enjoy my company as well as I would enjoy theirs. And you do have to sell yourself.
However, even with video dating, there is still the chance of rejection. Because once you have chosen someone who interests you, they are then allowed to view your tape. And if they like what they see, great. The video matchmaker arranges a meeting. But if they don't, well, it's only one of hundreds of potential partners. And judging from their success rate and growth, if the ratings weren't high the first time, chances are that it's sure to be a hit the next time around.
But sometimes you just don't find anything you like on TV.
Don't let that discourage you, because on a radio station in San Francisco, the number one hit of the night might just be you.
If you'd like to be on our special Valentine's edition of our Love Line, just give us a call at 474-KMPX. I'm Russ the Moose, and here's our next caller. Sarah?
Hi.
Hi, welcome to our Love Line, my dear. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself, Sarah? What do you look like, please?
Russ the Moose Syracuse has been a DJ on a San Francisco radio station for 16 years. People call in from all over Northern California and tell Russ who they are and what they're looking for in a mate. Other interested people listen till they hear someone who sounds just right. Russ calls this portion of his show the Love Line.
I think there's a need for a love line such as mine if just one person calls and finds somebody that they can relate to and have a good life together. I think it's worth it. But there's been many more than just one.
Russ can't tell you the number of successful dates he's arranged over the airwaves. But he does know of a few couples who, after hearing each other on the air, met, dated, and decided they were truly on the same frequency.
I have fallen in love with her, and I hope she's fallen in love with me. And I would like to ask her to marry me someday.
Do you think that if she heard you say that, she might call and answer?
I sure am hoping so.
I think I was the second one on here. And she made me wait until almost the end of the program.
Before she gave the answer.
Right, you know?
I'll accept that.
You are going to accept?
Yeah.
Well, that's really nice.
There's a lot of lonely people out there that don't want to go to bars and find women, you know, or a lot of organizations. It just doesn't work out. But Maybe they can find it this way. Just a telephone call helps sometimes if you're by yourself and lonely.
Hopefully, the people who call tonight will meet some real nice people, and who knows, maybe a nice lasting relationship for Sarah, for Karen, for Betty, for Ginny, for Tom, and we didn't quite get to Joe, but maybe tomorrow night we'll do it. All over again, right here on KMPX, Big Band 99 FM. I'm Russ the Moose, and I'm on the loose. Good night.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time.
There are, however, some people who prefer the simple approach. No video, no radio, no phones, just plenty of sunshine to keep you warm and plenty of company to keep you entertained. Now, you're probably asking yourself, what back issue of National Geographic will I find this tribe in? But you'll probably have better luck finding the answer in a travel brochure for Club Med. Club Med has 83 warm weather resorts all around the world, each one of them a kind of branch office of paradise. From the moment you step off the bus, the Club Med's GOs, or genteel organizers, make sure that your group spirit is kept alive. They gear the activities towards interacting with as many GMs, or genteel members, as possible. Now, all of this fun and games is not the sole province of the genteel members. Club Med encourages the GOs to socialize with the guests. As a matter of fact, most of the GOs aren't here for the money, but strictly for the fringe benefits.
Oh, they hang on you from the minute you get off the bus here, and they ask you to come up for backgammon lessons, and there's no backgammon boards. I've heard a couple of people talking about that, and it's a wild group that works here.
You don't have to be single to enjoy yourself at Club Med. The basic idea here is just to get away from it all. And that's an urge almost everybody shares. Men and women, singles and couples, even families with kids escape at Club Med resorts.
Well, I think that Club Med has a unique way of handling such activities. You can come as a family and be totally enjoyed as a family. And if you want to enjoy as singles, they have it so segregated that it doesn't interfere with anyone's privacy.
But if you are single, there's always the chance you might find more than a good time at this tropical retreat from reality. But what happens after you board the Bon Voyage bus and leave the Club Med magic behind? Well, that's entirely up to you.
Club Med is pretty wild, but it never would have existed without a sexual revolution. Next, we'll take a look at other results of this revolution, which changed all the rules, but even more, the roles.
We'll get a look at some other people who, in their own ways, have been breaking down cultural and sexual barriers, much like Club Med's GOs and GMs. So stay tuned for our very own GBD, that's genteel belly dancer, and others who may surprise you.
Remember when your best friend gave you a perm so frizzy you said, never again? Well, all that changed with the gentle soft perm called Rave. Rave has no odor, no ammonia, and no frizz. Rave proves softer and silkier, even on color-treated hair. Now that's a soft perm. So gentle, my sister had one, my neighbor, even my best friend.
Rave Soft Perm, now in extra curly, too.
We fill your days with song, capture memories, we make you smile.
GE, we bring good things to life.
At GE, we're in the business of making life a little better, and that's a pretty nice business to be in.
We bring you closer to the ones you love.
GE, we bring good things to live in. We bring good things to life. GE.
Can feel us coming now, a fresh look on the scene, with a whole new style of living, light and crisp and clean.
That's why now we say the age of 7-Up is here, cause we love that crisp, refreshing taste, so light and crystal clear. Move it up, look it up.
Hey, John McEnroe's turning 7-Up.
America is turning 7-Up, reach it up, feel it up.
Sugar Ray's turning 7-Up.
America is turning 7-Up.
Hey, Dad,
Come to Wendy's for our Father's Day double feature. Get a Gillette Atra-Pivoting Razor and Wendy's Double Hamburger and French Fries, all for only $2.49. Combine the great taste of Wendy's old-fashioned hamburgers with Gillette's best shave, the Atra Razor. Get a Wendy's Double, French Fries, and a 350 Gillette Atra Razor, all at a super savings price of $2.49. It's a great gift idea, too, at a fantastic price during Wendy's Father's Day double feature.
Wendy's old-fashioned.
Belly dancing has been around ever since there were belly buttons. It's a traditional art form, normally expressed by the female sex. However, we're in the midst of a sexual revolution with some pretty unpredictable results. More and more, over the past 10 years, women have been working in areas traditionally reserved for men. But the opposite is true, too.
Meet John Compton. You might say he's the first abdominal showman.
He hypnotizes you. He does. Once he looks into your eyes with his eyes, they're fantastic.
He's good looking, nice body, moves good. What else do you need?
I think every man should learn to move like he does.
I'm surprised. I don't walk down the street and see heads turn. But then all of a sudden I can get out there and they're screaming and yelling. I mean, I see people out there doing like what were happening in Beatle concerts. So I get so excited when I see them getting excited like that. It's like an adrenaline rush. It's something that's really hard to explain.
It's a wonderful boost to the ego.
Patrons usually show their appreciation for the dancer's art by tipping. But rather than leave one's money coldly on the table, customers are encouraged to become part of the show by placing their money on the dancer. But don't use credit cards. The edges hurt.
Where did you put your money?
Where did I put it? I put it on his hat band.
I put it on his cute little behind.
She told me I was going to see folk dancing, so I'm afraid I was very shocked. I probably won't go home the same.
I've never seen so many beautiful women react with such unbridled passion in all my life.
If you had John alone in a room, what would you do?
Take advantage of him. What else?
He could get away with anything.
I was disappointed.
Disappointed?
Yes, I was, because I wanted to see more of his body.
So you want a little less dancing and a lot more skin. Well, the 80s has a place for your tastes, too. Instead of suggestively peeling off feather boas and layers of lingerie, these new age skin stars are more likely to toss off a three-piece suit or a pair of boxer shorts.
It's nice being thought of as a sex object when all women were thought of as a sex object for so long. You can't feel anything sexual when you're out there really working. I mean, I think of it as a career. That's what I plan on doing for a living for a long while yet.
And just like their predecessors who go to those other strip joints, the women who patronize these clubs are out to drink, be loud, laugh, and see all they can. It's all fun, even with the tables turned.
I think it's great, and it's the best time we got something for women. It's good. A little embarrassing, but it's good.
I think it's fantastic. It's the greatest thing since bread and butter. And it's exactly what we need. It's about time.
Crazy about it. I have to. My sound's in it.
Male stripper clubs like this one in Las Vegas are opening all over the country, so don't be surprised if you find one nearby. But the most time-honored and traditional symbol of who's watching whom has always been the beauty contest. Only here the judges are women, and the contestants are men. In this 80s-style version of that event, the contestants still wear bathing suits, still parade down an elevated aisle, and still give their all for the judges.
I don't think it's a revolutionary or shocking thing. Times are changing. The pageant's meant to be fun. It's meant to make people feel good. And I feel our whole concept is here and today. There's no stopping an idea that has come.
guys are entrants in San Francisco's Man Watchers pageant. And whatever they've got, they're giving it their all for an approving nod from the ladies. Man Watchers president Susie Mallory explains what women are looking for these days.
Most men have the idea that we like Mr. Big Muscles, the Arnie Schwarzenegger type. And this is absolutely untrue. Our polls show that 96% consider large, grotesque muscles grotesque, basically. We like people in good condition, who are slim and trim, well-groomed, most important, able to communicate, because beauty is in the eye of the beholder, really. I think in this kind of grim world, we provide some fun. And, you know, I hope we make a lot of people feel good, because men need strokes just like women do.
But not all the contestants admitted they were looking for feminine approval.
I was looking for the Meatpackers convention room, and they steered me here. And before I knew it, the Men Watchers people had me in a bathing suit and signed me up.
I like to see women, you know, taking advantage of looking at men, you know, seeing them really say, we like to look at men too.
Wait a minute. Do we have to wear bathing suits?
It's interesting that despite their supposed lack of training for the job, the female judges had no trouble expressing their opinion of the men.
I'm looking for a man who is not worrying about whether he's a man or not, just the person. A good, fun human being.
Muscular arms, a slim waist, and nice long legs.
I really enjoy seeing men's legs, nice legs, myself, and nice forearms.
I think class. That's what I like in a man, is real class.
Hair on their arm, hair on their chest, hair on the back, hair on the legs. I just love hairy men.
I think they're just fantastic. It takes an awful lot of guts to do something like this.
Really, women are body watchers. I do a stand-up comedy act where we divide the male body into four different areas, the head being area one, chest area two, waist to upper thigh area three, and area four, the legs. Area three comes in first, then area two, area one, and area four, always in that order.
And the winners? Well, they've demonstrated that winning is winning, no matter what sex the winner is.
Something I didn't expect from this is that that lots of people meet people here. A lot of the fellas told me next year they're not bringing a lady to this. They're going to come by themselves.
For women who've been judged for years, the message for this contest is clear. Your turn has come. We'll be right back.
My gray hair makes me feel so old. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna wash that gray right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that gray right out of my hair.
Loving Care Color Lotion from Clairol washes away your gray and washes in your own natural color. Loving Care is different. It's gentle. It has no peroxide or ammonia.
So I wash that gray right out of my hair. Oh yes, I wash that gray right out of my hair.
Wash that gray right out of your hair with Clairol Loving.
Honey? I had that dream again. Termites.
Dennis, we've never seen any termites.
Jim Pollock didn't see them either, and he had $7,000 in damage.
So call Orkin.
Orkin, we're number one. We get the job done. We're Orkin.
You have nothing to worry about, sir. Orkin offers termite protection backed by a $100,000 written guarantee.
Good. Maybe we can get some sleep tonight.
We're Orkin.
In this age where traditions, mores, and customs are changing at an alarming rate, there is one institution that has more than endured. It's been called the birthplace of the liberated lifestyle, and for more than 20 years has kept that title. Playboy. The Playboy philosophy started out as a magazine editorial, but it wound up being a Bible for people who are looking for new ways of doing old things. In our next half hour, we'll see some of the ways that different folks have made different strokes out of everything from apartment living to partnerships. We'll see how far some people are going to avoid getting married, such as this couple's spin at the living together game, and how far others go to do just the opposite. So stay tuned, because when it comes to dating and mating, you ain't seen nothing yet.
How long is the warranty on this set?
Just look at that picture.
But the warranty.
The colors are so vivid.
The warranty.
And about this cabinet, it is genuine plastic.
I'm Curtis Mathis. We want you to know about our limited warranty. It's the longest in the business. 4 years. Why is ours that good? Simple. Our televisions are that good.
Curtis Mathis, the most expensive television in America, and worth it.
Make it rock, make it roll, give it a sock.
Something special at Burger King.
It's the Spot Saver Card.
With this, I could get a free specialty sandwich.
We'll give you a spot with each new specialty sandwich you buy.
Save up 5 spots.
And get your favorite specialty sandwich for free.
I've got spots before my eyes.
Match game tomorrow night at 7.
About all that we've looked at tonight, male strippers, female voyeurs, electronic dating, and all the rest of it, it's very symbolic. Not symbolic in the way that Freud might have looked at it, but symbolic of the new lifestyles that are emerging, the age of anything goes, a time when people aren't just looking for alternatives, they're trying them out. Nothing is sacred except making life easier and more enjoyable. And as radical and as different as some of these changes may appear to be, it's easy to pinpoint where they all began. Take right here, for example. If you haven't noticed all the telltale giveaways, this is a Playboy Club, a satellite outpost of the vast Playboy empire, a world ruled over for over 20 years by its creator and founder, Mr. Hugh Hefner. And now I know why he did it.
Well, I think that life is first and foremost for living. And I think that in the traditions and cultural values of America, there really has been primarily an orientation in terms of keeping up with the Joneses. The Puritan ethic is primarily a work ethic. We've been very good at working, but not very good at learning how to live life with a little style and really getting some enjoyment out of it. So my life has really been a combination of both those considerations. I've obviously worked very hard in order to accomplish what I've accomplished in 25 years, but I've had a great deal of pleasure in doing it.
Of course, Hugh Hefner has more reason than most of us to believe in the Playboy lifestyle. It's made him a multimillionaire and a captain of a virtual empire of enjoyable things, including this lavish Los Angeles mansion. The Playboy Mansion West is the ultimate expression of the Playboy philosophy's dedication to enjoyment. Maybe this place is the ultimate symbol of America's new way of life, but to most of us, it's still just a fold-out fantasy. It's too expensive. Unless you're as liberated financially as you are psychologically, you'll have to find some other way to put the Playboy philosophy to work. Which is what's happening in a growing number of single apartment complexes. You get a lot more than a roof over your head.
There's tennis for the trendy types and pool tables for the more traditionalists. A swimming pool where you can get a bit of exercise and even more exposure. And a jacuzzi bath where you and your neighbors can unwind together and occasionally wind up together. Actually, the neighbors are the real center of attention here. All the rest of this is just a pleasant backdrop to being single together.
I think it's the freedom that one gets, the not being tied down.
I'm open to anything and everybody, and I take it all as a learning experience.
I'm single for now, and I like it.
Is there anything different here that's gone on at this place as opposed to the other place that you live?
Yeah.
Like what? Tell me about it.
Oh, naked people in jacuzzi.
You have to admit, these places represent a big break with tradition. I mean, there was a time when living in a singles complex meant you were a prude. Now it means just the opposite.
Gwen, how did you get the title the King of the Jacuzzi?
You know, it beats me. We just happened to be partying one time and drinking quite a bit, and there's a few people running around and jumping in the pool and the jacuzzi, and some of the people didn't put any clothes on. I don't know what it was all about. So I just got involved. And the next thing I knew, you know, there's about 400 people watching the act. And so we had a party a couple of days later, and during this time, they presented me a crown, said Jacuzzi King. And a crown for the girls, said Jacuzzi Queen, you know.
And what happened at your prom?
At my prom? After we were crowned, we danced the big dance together out there, and then her boyfriend took her home.
Well, things certainly have changed, haven't they? But think about it. What are all these new ways of being single designed to do? They're designed to make you a happier and healthier person, which in turn makes you popular with more people, which leads you away from being single towards being together. But even being together has changed. Remember when unmarried couples were considered to be living in sin? Nowadays, they're just living in. Not getting married used to be a radical act. Now it's the safe way to have a relationship. Well, co-signing on a lease may be safer to some than saying till death do us part. But is it? I bet rock star Rod Stewart wouldn't say so. Or Alice Cooper. Or Peter Frampton either. But the biggest naysayer of them all is probably this man, Lee Marvin. Ever heard the word palimony? No, it's not the horse that Roy Rogers and Dale Evans rode down all those happy trails with. Palimony is the word used to describe the financial settlement you might be saddled with if those happy trails turn into a dead end for you and your unmarried roommate. Lee Marvin, of course, gave his name to the concept of palimony in a landmark lawsuit called Marvin versus Marvin. And attorney Marvin Mitchelson is the man who won the case for Lee's ex-pal, Michelle.
Well, the reason I took the Marvin case to begin with was because I thought there was a very big gap in the law that effectively deprived people who lived together of any rights at all when they broke up their relationship. And women who'd been together with a man 15, 20, 10 years, 5 years, whatever length of time, but who had contributed something to the acquisition of the property that both those people had, did not have access to the front door of the courthouse and had no rights at all. I thought that was wrong and unfair and discriminatory. And the Marvin case says that people should treat each other fairly and tries to find different ways to do that.
I'm proud to have paved the way for people in relationships such as mine. And I think that I think the next woman will win exactly what she was asking for.
It may have taken rich celebrities to try such an earth-shaking case as Marvin versus Marvin, but it doesn't take fame or fortune to feel the effects of that case. Larry and Wendy are not celebrities. In fact, they've never been on television before, but they have been living together for 3 years, and they did agree to play the living together game for our cameras. We asked each of them to list what would be rightfully theirs in the event their relationship fell apart. To make it even more interesting, they made their list separately without consulting each other. When they finished tearing their love nest apart, they found that they were each grasping at some of the same straws.
Silver and crystal collection, antique Chinese robe, and the stereo system.
Gotta be kidding.
All right, stereo system. Well, that's complicated because I had the original one and sold its various parts so that we could get this one.
Which I mostly paid for.
Oh, you can have the waterbed for the stereo.
I'll have to figure that out.
Wendy and Larry can laugh about their disagreements. After all, they were just playing a game. But separations do happen. And though the unhappy experience of breaking up isn't what people just getting started want to think about, their relationships might be better off if they did. And maybe that's where this handy little volume comes in. Another indicator of how mating and dating has changed in the 80s. It's written by two lawyers, Tony Ihara and Ralph Warner, who are also lovers. And it's designed to make breaking up as easy as getting together, at least on paper. The authors view their book as relationship insurance.
I think that a lot of people have a reluctance to enter into a contract just because contracts to most people mean something complicated. And contracts that are written between two people who are living together can be very simple. And what we like to do is call them agreements rather than contracts, just to get away from that image.
And what we do in the Living Together Kit is just simply show people the form of how to write it down.
In the 80s, it is important for people to have agreements and to talk about what it is they're feeling about their property, about their lifestyle, about what their understandings are, and especially because of the court recognition of people who are living together.
One answer we often give to people who say, aren't contracts unromantic, is very simple. A superior court is a whole lot less romantic than taking 15 minutes and jotting down what your understanding is.
Of course, this new age of ours isn't just creating new problems to be solved. It's also opening up new opportunities as well.
In the chilly hours and minutes of uncertainty, I want to be in the warm hold of your love and mine.
Georgia Holt is the 52-year-old mother of rock superstar Cher. Craig Spencer is 31. They've been living together for more than 4 years and loving it as much as they seem to love each other.
The first year for me was just, every time we'd go into a restaurant, you know, I would just be, is everybody looking, you know? And then after a while, I stopped caring about what other people, because I was happy with him, and I thought, you know, I've been trying to please other people all my life, and I'm going to do what feels right for me.
Georgia's decision to pursue her relationship with Craig didn't come easily. It followed on the heels of no fewer than 6 broken marriages. Even more troublesome was the fact that her daughter Cher's musical stardom has made Georgia's private life a kind of public property, but without the financial rewards that usually come with being a celebrity.
I think Craig is more fun than any man my age. I mean, there's more enthusiasm and silliness, and, you know, we play like children when we're alone, and we carry on and, you know, talk baby talk, which I've never talked except to my children when they were, you know, babies. He makes life more fun for me. He makes it more interesting. At the same time, even we don't have money, but I feel more protected by Craig than I ever have with any other man.
The advantages of me going with someone Georgia's age, people never see them. They never see them. They look at her and they say, oh,
they look
God,
at my
she's
face.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
she's gorgeous. She's got a daughter who's a big star. She obviously has a lot of money. She has a daughter who's a big star who I've never owned a record of. She is beautiful. That's a plus. Money? No. We have no money. We worry about bills like everybody else. That's why we're working, trying to get something done.
That's for sure, too.
But what she gives me is a maturity. She's given me something that I wasn't able to find in my age bracket. If she weren't the person that I see in front of me visually, I would still love her as much as I do because she has what she has in her.
There's nothing new about love affairs between people of different ages, but the time has finally come when an older woman can choose a younger man. Another role reversal, 80s style. It would seem, after visiting the people and places we've just seen, that tradition is rapidly being replaced by the unconventional. No wonder Dear Abby's being asked for all that advice. With values and traditions falling by the wayside, one has to wonder, what happened to all that romance? We'll find out in just a minute.
Spaghetti, huh? Tony must be coming for dinner.
With a few friends.
A few friends? Put on some more sauce.
No matter how many friends drop by, they'll all love spaghetti with lots and lots of ragu sauce.
Oh, no, 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 Sally. Sit next to me.
Terrific.
What did I tell you? Twirl it, Sally.
I think I'm coming back. I think I'm moving in.
Tony, you got nice friends.
Ragu spaghetti sauce. That's Italian.
Can your hair pass this physical fitness test? Does it shine? Is it silky? Is it manageable? Then get into condition. Clairol's physical fitness plan for out-of-shape, flabby hair. Protein-enriched Condition Shampoo. Condition 2 Instant After Shampoo Treatment. And Condition Beauty Pack. The twice-a-month intense treatment. Get into condition. It'll leave your hair physically fit.
Take your last look at good old Fresca. Because now there's a new Fresca with a fresh new taste. A fresh new taste that comes from a delicious blend of citrus flavors. New Fresca is still sugar-free, still low-calorie. With a unique new taste you'll enjoy again and again. Take your first look at new sparkling clear Fresca. Now, try the fresh new taste.
You Butch, that's ours.
Oh, that's all right, Linda. You'll get his meat protein from Alpha Beef Flavored Dinner.
Meat protein in a dry?
Sure. One serving of Alpha Beef Flavored Dinner has as much meat protein as this 7-ounce sirloin.
Lauren, he loves it.
Told you. Alpo Dry. One serving has as much meat protein as this 7-ounce sirloin.
I should have known it. As long as there are soft lights, background music, people to mix with, and bartenders to mix for them, romance as we know it is not dead. Singles leading the liberated life and leading the way into the future are looking back at the past and learning from it. Traditions are being revived and rejuvenated for that leap into the 80s. For example, you can leap into love on board a seaborne excuse for a singles bar called a Love Boat. But no romance is really a romance without a payoff. And the ultimate romantic payoff is the marriage proposal. But getting down on one knee wasn't Brian's idea when he asked Shirley to marry him.
See, all right? Here's a glass of champagne. There you are.
This may be the world's foremost example of how being in love is bigger than both of us. As big as a billboard.
I told you I loved you.
Said the old man trying to tell me too.
What are you going to say?
Yes, yes, yes!
As you can see, champagne and flowers are hardly things of the past. Actually, marriage proposals are more in than ever. In fact, today, the U.S. is considered the most married country in the world. Scenes such as this and this still take place every day. But America's relentless search for the new and different has caught up with a lot of these familiar sights. And in one instance, even turned the wedding march into a glide. But even marriage as a show business-like production isn't really an 80s thing entirely. There's one world-famous town where for years some of America's most famous folks have gotten together in a big way, including Arlene Dahl, Rhonda Fleming, and even that everlasting Johnny-come-lately, Mickey Rooney. Here in Las Vegas, getting married is a full-blown industry, complete with sets. This one is called the Little Church of the West. Props, everything from bouquets to the indispensable handful of rice. and even a stage manager who makes sure it all happens on time.
Well, some girl that works for me has to have a little finesse. She gets them in. We do the wedding, and you have to do it nice. You can't offend the people. But still, you have to move them. So you give them the rice and tell them to go out and throw the rice on the bridegroom, and tell the bride and groom to walk around the walk, and they'll throw the rice at them. This gets them out. If they didn't, they'd stand there and talk to each other all afternoon, you know, and you can't do this.
Well, love and marriage may go together like a horse and carriage, but as you've just seen, in Las Vegas, they also go together very quickly. Despite the old line that getting married and living happily ever after, marriage isn't the end of a story. It's the beginning. And no matter how other things may have changed, most marriages still begin with, that's right, a honeymoon. Of the 2.5 million Americans who will get married this year, over 10% will spend their honeymoon in a place like this. This is Cove Haven in Pennsylvania's Pocono Mountains. It's a honeymoon resort, and it caters to the newlywed. Although the idea of having a place for honeymooners has only been with us since 1945, the term honeymoon originated in the 16th century. It was used to describe the bliss-filled state of newlyweds before the realities of married life set in. Places like Cove Haven are dedicated to keeping that 16th century idea alive.
How about a little reservation at the honeymoon hotel?
Everything at these places says romance. Actually, it doesn't say it. It shouts it. But apparently, when you're a 1980s newlywed, nothing can be overdone. For those newlyweds who enjoy it, a hot sauna. After that, a dip in the pool. Now, there is nothing unique about a sauna and a pool. However, this is all located in your bedroom.
Bring along your things and all your kisses to the honeymoon hotel.
It's perfect. It's nice. It's not very crowded right now. Quiet. You can be alone. Everything's geared to couples. And the room's just perfect. It's like a romantic apartment for two that you wouldn't have in your own home.
First thing we did when we got here, we opened the door up and jumped in the tub with the clothes on just to see if it fit.
Ah, yes, the bathroom. It used to be the least talked about place in the house. But now surveys tell us that brides rate it numero uno in importance, a fact reflected in the fixtures here at Cove Haven. Obviously, these places are designed to provide everything a newlywed couple could want to make their honeymoon a success. You can even have your own professional photographer to record the fleeting moments of your very first nuptial bubble bath. At Cove Haven, his name is Foxy. And as he tells it, all you have to provide is the bubbles.
Never forget this instant where a guy asked me to take the picture that he would like have taken in the tub. Now, he had everything set up, and finally he called me into the bathroom. When I walked in there, she was under the bubbles in the tub. And he had a snorkel, swim mask, and fins. And he went into the tub with her, okay? And all you could see of him was a snorkel and the fins, or the feet sticking up, and her, of course, lying on her back in the bubbles. That was gotta be the cutest or most different shot I've ever taken under the bubbles.
A bubble bath probably does break down a lot of barriers, but Cove Haven wants its couples to get to know more about each other than how hot to make the water. Which, believe it or not, is what these couples are trying to do, Cove Haven style. Despite what it looks like they're doing, they're actually getting to know each other better by playing games. Games that prove it isn't winning or losing. It's how you play that counts.
There you go. Squeeze. Put your arms around your husband, honey. Sure, squeeze one more time. Guaranteed to work. Squeeze. Hold on, Omar. Hold on, Omar. All right.
Did any of the games upset you?
Oh, no. I just felt a little embarrassed at first, and then you work your way in there.
What embarrassed you,
man? Just the fact that I was standing up there with a silly ping pong ball and had to stick it in his pants.
What about you? Did any of the games embarrass you?
No, not really, to be honest with you. Yeah. I figure around all newlyweds.
Everybody's doing it, so you know, why
exactly
not do it?
Exactly, everybody's doing it.
Get him, lady, get him. Hurry, hurry, hurry.
However, if the gyrations of a getting-to-know-you game aren't your cup of tea, all you have to do is wait for the gyrations of the Cove Haven Disco, where newlyweds can dance the night away, or at least part of it. Honeymoons, of course, are supposed to be for newlyweds. That's the whole idea behind this place. But it seems that a lot of others are getting into the act, too. Darius Velarde is a public relations agent who spent 20 years as Cove Haven's social director.
We turned the place over completely on the weekend, again, with a big Friday check-in, with couples who just want to get away for the weekend. Not honeymoon couples, but couples who may have been here before or may have heard about the place through their friends and looking to rejuvenate their wedding vows or whatever, and got indoor ice skating, indoor roller skating, indoor shooting range, miniature golf, a gymnasium, a pool room, billiard room, an indoor archery room. In the wintertime, when we're fortunate enough to have snow on the property, we have snowmobiles and toboggans and sleds, and in the summer, we have unlimited water skiing and speedboat riding and horseback riding. It's on and on and on. You couldn't possibly do all the activities unless you stayed a month in it.
Some people feel that the romance has gone out of American life. Obviously, that isn't true. Marriages are actually on the upswing. And from the popularity of places like this, it's obvious that swinging singles make good mates.
You know, everyone said, Carolyn, open a restaurant. So I did.
Hey, number one.
Now it's lunch for 100 every day, plus menus and reservations and hiring people. Oh, hello.
Hi.
Glad you could be
number one.
And every day without fail, I take my one-a-day plus iron.
You're number one.
It's got 100% full potency of iron, and I want to make sure I get all the iron my hard-working body needs.
Here's so, the one.
Hey, number one.
Friends, Herbert Hoover hid out in the White House, too, responding to desperate problems with patriotic pronouncements. And we got a hell of a depression. But I'm afraid Jimmy's depression is going to be worse than Herbert's. I'm supporting Senator Kennedy because he's out there facing issues. Inflation, sky-high prices, an almost worthless dollar, unemployment. I trust Ted Kennedy. I believe in him. In every way, folks.
Kennedy for president. We gotta fight back.
The two of us may not agree on abortion, but we do agree that you should vote against Issue 6.
Issue 6 is a bad law for both sides. It's bad for us who oppose abortions because it doesn't stop abortions. It just makes them more dangerous.
Neither one of us wants government red tape delaying abortions and creating more danger for the woman.
Issue 6 is dangerous to women's health. So on June 3rd, vote against Issue 6. That's something we can all agree on.
Here comes the big beefsteak taste of McDonald's new chopped beefsteak sandwich.
Nobody.
The big taste of chopped beefsteak.
A big new taste for you, nobody.
Served on a toasted French roll with slivers of onion.
It's big.
Nobody.
And our special recipe steak sauce on the side.
You're the reason we do it. Nobody can do it like McDonald's can. We made it just for you.
New chopped beefsteak sandwich.
Well, tonight we've taken an informal look at what the 80s have to offer those of us who are pursuing any of the lifestyles we've just seen. Yes, the next decade is going to be a pretty wild one. But I'll tell you what. You meet me back here in 1990, bring your electrocution initials and video cassette. I'll bring my Club Med card, Playboy key, and roller skates. And we'll see how much of it's nostalgia. Till the next time, this is Bill Rafferty.
Hold me, control me, 'cause I
Ohio, Ohio.
Did you ever see a place so wonderful? How would it feel to relax with us this year? Little children love it, big folks like it too. There's a land of wonderment awaiting you.
WTOL-TV, Toledo 11.
Straight from the newsroom, this is Toledo 11 News Break.
Good evening. In what some consider a landmark case, a federal judge in Toledo has approved an out-of-court settlement in a five-year class action suit against Owens, Illinois, charged with discriminating against women in employment practices. The company agreed to pay $122,000 in back wages to women involved in the suit, plus thousands of dollars in legal fees and court costs. Now this.
New Sicilian pan pizza from Pizza Hut, made by hand right in the pan.
Boy, is it ever good.
We're coming into Pizza Hut, coming in for good.